Hello, my name is Isagani Cruz. I want to welcome you to a lesson in a telecourse for students and teachers of literature. This lesson is divided into two parts. In the first part, students will learn how to read a short story entitled The Cask of Amontillado by Edgar Allan Poe of the United States. To help students understand the story, we will listen to an American teacher of literature, Thomas Crowell. In the second part, teachers will learn how to use the teaching method known as virtual filmmaking. To show teachers how the method works in the classroom, an outstanding teacher from the Department of Education, Azucena Erencio, will do a demonstration class with third-year students of the Manila Science High School.
By the last breath of the four winds that blow, I'll have revenge upon Fortunato. Smile in his face, I'll say, come, let us go. I've a cask of Amontillado, sheltered inside from the cold of the snow. Follow me now to the vault down below, drinking the wine as we laugh at the time, which is passing incredibly slow.
Revenge. Revenge is also one of the most popular themes of literature. Why do we read literature about revenge? Why do we read literature at all? Because reading literature is the best way to understand who we are, what we used to be, and what we can be. Every time we read a short story, even a short story about evil, even about revenge, we become better persons because we learn to understand ourselves. One of the best known short stories about revenge comes from the pen of an American writer named Edgar Allan Poe. Let us ask an American teacher about the story.
Outside of the United States, Edgar Allan Poe may be better known than any other American writer. There's something about his short stories and poems that seems to interest people the world over. Perhaps it's the sense of macabre or the recognition that we all have a dark side that motivates us to read Poe's stories like The Cast of Amontillado or poems like The Raven. The stories by Poe that people read today are the ones that are filled with fear, terror, and death. They deal with murders of revenge or murders without reason. They tell of strange, unreal events in a way that they seem real. His stories are really a precursor to the horror films of today that maintain their popularity despite the number of sequels that have been produced of films like Nightmare on Elm Street or Scream. The child of two actors, Edgar Poe was born in Boston in 1809. His father deserted the family before Poe was even 1 year old, and his mother died when he was just two. He was taken into the home of a wealthy tobacco merchant, John Allen, and Allen's wife treated Poe like a real son. She had no children of her own. Poe later chose to use the name Allen as his middle name to show respect for this couple, his adopted mother in particular. The Allens provided Poe with a good education, including schools in Britain, where the family lived for nearly 6 years. At the age of 17, Poe began studies at the University of Virginia, but dropped out after 1 year when his father withdrew support because of Poe's newfound habits of gambling and excessive drinking. He enlisted in the army, serving for 2 years and reaching the rank of sergeant before he was discharged at the age of 20. Shortly afterwards, he won an appointment to the prestigious United States Military Academy at West Point. But this too did not work out, and in less than 1 year, he was court-martialed for disobedience.
The Cast of Amontillado has two characters, a man named Montresor, who is about 80 years old, very old and dying, talking about another man named Fortunato. In the story, Montresor confesses to someone very close to him, perhaps a priest, perhaps his wife, perhaps a close relative, that 50 years ago, Fortunato insulted him, and he killed Fortunato in revenge. Montresor confesses that he buried Fortunato alive in a wine cellar and left him to die. Suppose someone gave us a lot of money to make a film based on the short story by Edgar Allan Poe. How would we go about it? Let us form groups of five. Each group should pretend that it has been given plenty of money to come up with a movie based on the short story. Each group should come up with a poster about the movie. Indicate the title, which should be attractive to moviegoers. Indicate the cast. Pretend that you can use real actors. Is it horror, mystery, a detective story, or an action film? This is the end of the first part of the lesson. The rest of the lesson is meant for teachers. When we teach literature, we can follow the paradigm for teaching literature that is called FREE. F for feeding the text. R for reading the text. E for enhancing the text. E for enjoying the text. There are many ways to teach the short story. In this lesson, we feed the text by telling students who Edgar Allan Poe is and what his short story is about.